I thank God for this opportunity to stand before His wonderful, beautiful people. I want to thank each and every one of you in your respective places for being here today. I hope you came expecting God to move in your life today, to begin to stir up a place within you that has not been touched for a while. I truly believe that God is in this place. Don't get sidetracked with where we are. I want you to know that He is the God that can fight in the high place. And He can come down to the low place, into the valley, and He can do battle and yet win. See, we're going to get in agreement here. We're not going to let the four walls hinder us and hinder the anointing of God, because He said that I am. And I am is in this place today. And I want you to know today that your mouth is a weapon of warfare. You need to open up your mouth in this place and give God a shout in this place. And give Him the praise and give Him the honor and give Him the glory that is due unto Him, we are wasting our time. We've come for form and we've come for fashion, and we'll leave the way we came in.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
See, I got a little distracted too, and I had a program and I wanted to have a conference, and I was excited about that. See, in a conference, you don't have to raise your voice too loud. And I don't have to even invite God to come in until maybe at the end somewhere. But He said to me, did I call you to do a conference? Did I call you to do a conference? Do you truly believe that you could go and impact my people without me? What can I say? What life-giving power is in me that I can give you except the Holy Spirit of God, the fire of God, the power of God, the anointing of God that destroys every yoke? I don't know how far some of you come from. I know the prophetess Marcus Williams has come as far as Georgia, and he didn't call it a dishonor to come into this place today. He's a man of fire and with power. And He came in today. He didn't come to see the prophetess. He came to see, to have a meeting with the great I Am. I know the woman of God came today. We have a prophetess, Miriam, of flowers in the house today. Bless God. She didn't come to see a prophetess per se, but she came to see what God is doing and what He's stirring up in this place at this time. Yes. And we're not going to be hindered. We're going to get on one accord, and we're going to get what we came to get. Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's get our hearts and our minds focused on him. And I mean, you are in the overflow because you've been in his presence. You've been revived. Now it's time for the deposit of God, the empowerment that has already begun for the accelerator to the next level, that you know that you have what it takes to make it to December and go into destiny. Hallelujah. So at this time, I just want to acknowledge the woman of God. Woman of God, Rome, God bless you. Prophetess Tammy Mitchell, I thank you for your friendship. She is the president of the chapter of Women with a Call. We have men in here as well, and we all have a call and a purpose. And God is going to activate in this place. He's going to anoint. He's going to send out. He's going to charge up. There's some atmosphere that you walk into. When you come out of that atmosphere, you just can't sit down. You just got to do something. Because you're impregnated. You feel the fire of God. You feel the power of God. You got to do something about what he's deposited in your spirit. Hallelujah. He's about to charge it up. He's about to fire up. All it's going to take is one spark. It only takes a spark to get the fire going. Do you know how it takes is a little spark to burn it all down? And he's going to spark your spirit. Some of you might need to be jump started, but you're going to be started in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. God is doing something in this place. Hallelujah. And we're not going to be afraid of his moving, his empowerment, his power. Let him do what he wants to do today. Let him do it in your spirit. When I leave here today, I know God is going to do something in me. There's going to be a shifting in the spirit. I'm going to another level. All I'm asking you to do is go with me to your next level, wherever that might be today. Let him do it. Let him have his way. It's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by his spirit. Yeah. Hallelujah. He'll do it. He'll do it by his spirit. I thank God. The woman with a call. The Apostle Elizabeth Houston. She is the founder, and we thank God for her. We appreciate this opportunity. We thank God for the visionary, because there's so many people you got blocking before they'll promote you. They'll compete against you before they'll help you. So we thank God for someone with such a vision to promote women in ministry that they may do what God has called them to do. And I thank God also just for the opportunity last night to visit the Empowering Lives Outreach Ministry. Because that's what it is all about. Empowering, releasing, and letting God's people do what God has called them to do. So we worship him in this place. We bring our hearts on one accord. The greatest thing that we need to do is have a heart connection. His heart connected to our heart. And there'll be a direct deposit, a direct connecting, a direct movement from him to us and from us to him. The umbilical cord connected and empowered that we might receive. Jesus' name. We need to be there today. You know, the Lord began to talk to me last night, and he said to me, you know, as I said, I wanted to have a conference. I wanted to have all the little papers, and I wanted everybody to do little, you know, you do all little activities. And then when we're finished, then we could invite him and he could have empowered us and all that pretty little stuff. And it was going to be fun. But he had another. He had another agenda. And today, I honor his agenda. I'm going to follow him. Of my obedience today. God, we bless you in this place. It's not by power, it's not by might, but it's by his spirit. If you'll close your eyes for just 1 minute. Father, we just want to thank you and praise you for this opportunity to be in your presence right now. Father God, we want to praise you because we came expecting you to touch us. We came expecting you to speak to us. We came expecting to be changed. Oh Lord God, even in the twinkling of an eye, that there be a difference, an impartation, and stirring up. The power of God will fall upon us afresh. That you will blow on us and renew us again, oh God. We came, oh God, to be charged up. We're taking the first step and we're coming out. We know play with God like that. See, the word empowerment, and I'm going to break it down for you, prefix, suffix, base word, stem. I want to break it down for you because I want to get into your spirit. The prefix M is a variation of EN. EN indicates what it is that the stem is talking about. In other words, if we are talking about power, M said, I enthrone, go back to the stem, which is power. Whatever it is, the condition, the state of mind, the being, that stem indicates. things all lined up. Good education, certain things, you know, a good pedigree, come from a good family. And you speak the proper way and you do things the right way. You might not be qualified to be empowered, to be in a position where you can impact the lives of other people. So as I am talking, I want you to think about that for just 1 minute. What is it? And I want you to write it down to yourself between you and your God. What is it that you came here for? Hopefully you didn't come to see a man. You didn't come to eat or drink, but you came to get something that you can't get from anywhere else, but only from the hand of God. Say, I need something today. I need something today. That's why I want to let him do whatever he feels like doing up here today. If he says open up the book, I'm going to open up the book. If he says stay right where you are, that's where I'm going.
Amen.
Love people.
Amen.
And love And because everything is so relational, we can't get distracted with all the barriers that people put up.
Yes.
Do you know people put up barriers?
Right.
And we often misread those barriers. We see the prim, proper, performer, the goody-two-shoe woman, and automatically there's something that rises up in our spirit that hates her because she just seems too perfect. But I came to let you to know today that maybe she's fighting some insecurities. Maybe she doesn't want you to like her because maybe you can change her and maybe you can empower her if she just looked the way you want her to look. Then you will feel like you can relate to her. But people put up barriers because they've been hurt. They've been beaten. They've been taken advantage of. They're tired. Some of us have played the role of the tough girl. We hide behind a wall that's impenetrable. We desire relationships. We hunger and thirst after it. And yet we put up the wall and the back can reach us.
Amen.
And we can't let these people